This timeline of COVID-19 reveals many dark secrets of Freemasons and connects all the dots back to the CIA bioweapon lab in Fort Detrick, USA. SARS-CoV-2 is a bioweapon of the Anglo-Saxon mission targeting China. This Anglo-Saxon conspiracy went out of hand. Before they managed to bomb Wuhan with the virus, it escaped from the CIA lab, spreading in the United States coast to coast, and to Europe and Japan, where the U.S. military has its bases. The COVID-19 timeline began in 1910, or even earlier, when Jack London, an honorary member of the Bohemian Club, published a short novel titled, The Unparalleled Invasion, teaching the West how to wipe out China by secret bio-warfare, so that they might divide the land of China for themselves, just as they had divided up the Americas for themselves. Jack London got his inspiration for the Unparalleled Invasion from the Bohemian Club, a restricted and private gentleman's club, at Bohemian Grove in California, United States. Jack London believed the Anglo-Saxon is the race of mastery, the breed of the salt of the earth. The salt of the earth is a title Yeshua given to his disciples, because they are the ones preserving the truth and shining for the truth, like salt preserving food and enhancing the flavor of food. Jack London grossly misused God's word, calling the grossest holy. In 1943, U.S. Army Biological Warfare Laboratories to culture the bioweapons of Jack London were established in Fort Detrick, with 1,600 Nazi war criminal scientists and engineers from Germany and Austria, and all the Japanese war crime scientific data, working for the Anglo-Saxon mission. The Fort Detrick bioweapons were later used on North Korea and China during the Korean War. The Fort Detrick is also the site where the COVID-19 virus was engineered against China. In 1968, U.S. President's science advisor Gordon MacDonald set the timeline for bio-warfare. By 2018, technology would be available for secret warfare against competitors. Secret warfare will be used to thoroughly weaken the enemy's population before overt armed forces to take over. Just as plotted by Gordon MacDonald, after the U.S. bombed Wuhan with the COVID-19 virus, it held an island assault exercise, featuring an MQ-9 Reaper drone, superimposed over a red silhouette of China. It would be a real war on China, not an exercise, had the virus not leaked from the CIA lab, and greatly weakened the U.S. Army, before they bombed Wuhan, and had China failed to kill the pandemic quickly. The pretext for the real war on China would be that China refuses to pay compensation for spreading COVID-19. The goal of the war is to carve up China, as scripted in Jack London's novel. In 1981, U.S. Vatican writer Dean Kuntz published a novel, which mentions a Russian bioweapon named Gorky 400, after a famous Russian city. In his 1989 edition, after the Soviet Union became the friend of the U.S., however, the Russian bioweapon was renamed Wuhan 400, after a famous Chinese city, suggesting COVID-19 is not only a U.S. bioweapon against China, but also a U.S. false flag operation, to blame it on China, their victim. In 1996, the Anglo-Saxon mission was on track. They recovered the RNA of the most lethal virus ever known. The 1918 influenza originated in the U.S., where the first known case was reported at a military base in Kansas on March 11, 1918. Possibly a bioweapon leak during World War I. That virus killed 500 million people, or one-third of the world's population. In 2001, the United States rejected a protocol to strengthen the Biological Weapons Convention, despite 6 years of international negotiation. By April 2002, the Anglo-Saxon mission was already equipped with the technology to produce recombinant coronavirus, half a year before the 2002 SARS pandemic struck China. This reveals a horrible truth: that even the 2002 SARS pandemic was an Anglo-Saxon bio-attack on China, a trial for their new-found bioweapons. As Dr. David Martin put it, the U.S. made SARS and blamed it on China.
In 1999, Anthony Fauci funded research at the University of North Carolina, Chapel Hill, specifically to create, and you cannot help but you know, lament what I'm about to read, because this comes directly from a patent application filed on April 19th, 2002. And you heard the date correctly, 2002, where the NIAID built an infectious replication defective coronavirus that was specifically targeted for human lung epithelium. In other words, we made SARS. We made SARS.
In 2004, the CDC filed patent application for coronavirus isolated from humans and infections detecting methods, so that the CDC alone may perform coronavirus diagnostic tests. This effectively helped the CDC disguise the COVID-19 lab leak from Fort Detrick in 2019 as vaping illness, respiratory disease with unknown cause, and flu. In her 2004 and 2008 books, Sylvia Brown, founder of the Gnostic Christian Church, a self-proclaimed psychic, loosely revealed the Masonic Anglo-Saxon mission COVID-19 plot in the form of vaticination. In 2005, senior Freemasons met in the City of London to follow up their long-plotted bioweapon COVID-19 conspiracy on China. China will catch a cold, they declared.
Now, this is a British person, and he worked in the British military for a number of years, and after he retired from the military, he worked in the City of London in a fairly senior position, in a respected position in the City of London. Our source attended a number of meetings with senior Masons, and while many of these were interesting, they were routine by City of London standards. They were discussing financial affairs and so on and so forth. And then in the June 2005, he attended another meeting that he thought was going to be a routine meeting, but actually this was something rather unusual. At first he didn't even understand what was being discussed. Now, the people there were Masons. There were senior Masons. They were about 25 or 30 people there, including senior politicians who most people in the UK would recognize by name. The chief of police was there, representatives from the church, representatives from the military, 25 or 30 people. And what they were talking about was a plan that had clearly been made a long time ago, and what they were discussing was they were discussing the implementation of this plan. They were discussing how things were going, whether they were on track or not. The first thing that he heard was they were talking about the fact that Israel didn't look as if it was getting prepared to attack Iran anytime soon. This was a problem. Then they were talking about China and how powerful China was getting, both militarily and financially, very quickly, and that the Japanese weren't doing what they were supposed to do, which was to interfere in some way with the Chinese financial system. They weren't doing that, and this was another problem because China was getting too strong too quickly. Other things that were discussed were, for example, the coming financial crash, the centralization of resources, everything that we saw starting to happen in October 2008, they were planning that and referring to it in their meeting in June 2005. Now, what he described is what the sequence of events was. It starts with Israel attacking Iran. The plan is for either Iran or for China to retaliate after Iran is struck with a nuclear weapon. At that point, there will be a limited nuclear exchange in the Middle East, followed by a ceasefire. He heard this being planned in this meeting. This is being choreographed. It's like the script for a movie. This is exactly what's intended to happen. During the time of this ceasefire, everyone's shocked, everyone's frightened, everyone's really terrified about where this is going to go. There are all kinds of heavy controls over populations everywhere. And then the next thing that happens in this chess game that's being played is that biological weapons are released on China. He heard this being discussed in this meeting. They will release a flu-like virus that will be genetically targeted against the Chinese population. It's racially targeted against the Chinese people. It's designed to spread like wildfire and to knock out a large number of the Chinese people. And these people in this meeting were laughing about this. They said, China will catch a cold. Those were their words. China will catch a cold. And they were laughing about the fact that these biological weapons will wreak havoc among the Chinese population. And after that, then what effectively will be a kind of plague will actually spread right across the world to the West as well. And then, he said, then the real war starts. Something that would be justifiably called the Third World War with a much more major nuclear exchange. At this point, I asked him, is this just about population reduction? What is this about? Why are they doing this? He said, absolutely, it's about population reduction. Absolutely, it's about population reduction. So I said, well, in this meeting, did they mention any figures? And he said, yes, they did, 50%. Half the world's population, this is planned as per the Georgia Guidestones, and 50% is a step towards that. Then he said that they have a name for this plan. This project has got a name. And I said, well, what is this name? He said, it is called the Anglo-Saxon Mission. The Anglo-Saxon Mission.
This is the Anglo-Saxon Mission sequence of events, and how the God of Israel caused them to miss their target, so that their plan backfired. Israel refused to nuke Iran as they planned. Instead, Israel prayed for the death of Iranian nuclear scientists, and they all died, one by one, to save both the people of Israel and the people of Iran. As it is written, it is better that one man to die for the people, not that the whole nation should perish. As event 1 did not happen, events 2, 3, and 4 were all strangled in the Anglo-Saxon womb. The Anglo-Saxon Freemasons succeeded in bombing Wuhan with their bioweapon COVID-19 virus, only after their bioweapon escaped from the CIA lab and had infected all United States from coast to coast. That's why the U.S. already had 5 million people infected between October 2019 and January 2020, while China only had 200 cases, according to the IgG test of U.S. blood donation samples collected. When the U.S. fake flu, true COVID-19, had killed 10,000 in the U.S. by the 31st of January 2020, the U.S. bioweapon had only managed to kill 259 in China. Even Canada admitted that their early COVID-19 cases came from the U.S., not from China. COVID-19 did not spread from China to the world as they wanted. So, their China lab leak conspiracy theory to demonize the Chinese collapsed by itself. Not only that, Yahweh, the God of Israel, helped China put the pandemic under control, and turned the Anglo-Saxon bioweapon on themselves, killing 630,000 Anglo-Saxons in USA alone, hallelujah. The Anglo-Saxon bioweapon COVID-19 has disabled their own troops. That's why they're withdrawing from Yemen, Afghanistan, and Iraq. The United States, the Anglo-Saxon war crime machine, is crumbling. Their Illuminati goal to reduce world population by 95% will never happen. However, the day is coming when mankind will be made scarcer than pure gold, when the Creator wipes out all the wicked. Their scientifically proven 2012 pole shift, a scientific doomsday theory, invented by demon-possessed Chan Thomas, and classified by the CIA for 50 years, didn't happen. The Anglo-Saxon mission planned a racist Nazi New World without the Chinese.
Our source suggests that the reason for this whole Third World War scenario is that then the Western governments, with the Chinese out of the way, will be in a state of such totalitarian control of their own population that they will be best equipped to recover and rebuild the new world after a cataclysm. This now is my own speculation right now. It's called the Anglo-Saxon mission. What that told me was that the reason for the name is because this is a white racist agenda for the inheriting of the new earth. It's a plan that Hitler would be proud of. If they think that a new earth needs to be rebuilt, a new world, think of that little phrase there, if a new world needs to be rebuilt after a cataclysm, they want the Anglo-Saxons to be doing it. They don't want the Chinese to be doing it. They get the Chinese out of the way first, and then the Anglo-Saxons will inherit this new world with the other nations, the Asian nations, the African nations, the South American nations. Presumably, it is assumed that they won't have the resources to be able to handle the situation in any kind of a way that gives them the strength to recover after whatever it is that they think is going to occur.
But Yeshua has included in his eternal kingdom his Chinese disciples from communist China, prophesied by Isaiah 2,700 years ago, 500 years before China came into being. Hallelujah! In 2005, in the same year of the Freemason meeting for China to catch a cold, the U.S. resurrected the 1918 flu virus. So, infecting China with the 1918 flu became possible in 2005. As soon as the 1918 flu virus was resurrected, U.S. President Bush announced plan for flu pandemic. Very telling, isn't it? This Anglo-Saxon bioweapon timeline clearly shows that the COVID-19 virus is a hybrid of coronavirus and influenza virus. Their technology was ready by early 2002. By the end of 2002, they ran a trial in Guangdong, China, and found it was not infectious enough, and it disappeared too soon. To make their bioweapon more destructive, they inserted HIV-like spike protein. So, by 2005, the Anglo-Saxon bioweapon was ready to strike. But their vaccines for self-protection had not been perfected. They could only bomb Wuhan at the end of 2019, because their bioweapon had escaped from their Nazi lab in Fort Detrick, early 2019. The U.S. COVID-19 lab leak is proved by ample circumstantial evidence, including these two bills with the same name, introduced early 2019, so that one of them will be amended as the CARES Act to speed up the legislative process. In 2010, the lockstep roadmap for the COVID-19 pandemic was laid out by the Rockefeller Foundation. The Rockefeller Report, Scenarios for the Future of Technology and International Development, concluded that pandemic, terrorism, environmental crises, and rising poverty will effectively force citizens to willingly give up their sovereignty and privacy in exchange for greater safety and stability. Also in 2010, Moderna was formed for production of mRNA vaccines and drugs. In 2011, a Warner Media thriller, Contagion, prepared the masses for the coming COVID-19 pandemic, where a lethal airborne bat virus, originated in China, would kill 26 million people. In 2012, the London Olympic opening ceremony, declared the Anglo-Saxon mission to the world's Freemasons in Masonic argo that they would make China catch a cold. In 2014, USNIH granted funding to EcoHealth Alliance, who works with Wuhan Institute of Virology, for bat coronavirus research project, a false flag to blame the U.S. bioweapon pandemic on China. The funding was cancelled in April 2020 after Wuhan was bombed with SARS-CoV-2, but was resumed in August 2020, so that the false flag op would not be so obvious. In 2015, patent application for coronavirus vaccine was filed in the U.S. and a hybrid version of a bat coronavirus, which can infect human cells, was created. The Anglo-Saxon bioweapon is being perfected. In 2016, Fauci predicted the COVID-19 pandemic on 60 Minutes.
A full 4 years before COVID-19 caused worldwide devastation, Dr. Fauci told us his greatest fear.
An influenza-like respiratory-borne virus that's easily transmittable, to which the population of the world has very little, if any, immunity against, and that has a high degree of morbidity and mortality, something similar to the very tragic pandemic flu of 1918.
Fauci always likens COVID-19 to influenza. The 1918 flu mentioned by Fauci originated in a U.S. military base. That U.S. flu, erroneously known as Spanish flu, had killed one-third of the world's population. Also in 2016, UK ran a pandemic exercise named Cygnus to prepare the Anglos for the coming bioweapon pandemic they had planned. Since 2016, at least two pandemic exercises were held in the West per year. All the exercises were against a flu-like novel coronavirus. Overwhelming circumstantial evidence points to Freemasons, Bill Gates, and the WHO as the planners and organizers of the COVID-19 pandemic, which was to start from China. In 2017, Fauci predicted the exact timing of the COVID-19 pandemic in Jesuits Georgetown University.
The idea that we are now a few days away from a new administration, given, as you heard from the introduction, that I have been around for a while and have had the opportunity of serving in five administrations, I thought I would bring that perspective to the topic today, is the issue of pandemic preparedness. And if there's one message that I want to leave with you today, is that there is no question that there will be a surprise outbreak.
Also in 2017, Bill Gates launched the CEPI pandemic simulation in Switzerland to outsmart global epidemics, while the U.S. held simulation against the SARS pandemic broke out in 2025, fighting an influenza-like illness caused by a novel coronavirus originated in Asia. In 2018, Bill Gates told Stat, COVID-19 will get a lot of countries before it gets the U.S.
Are you nervous about your own life and what could happen?
This thing will get a lot of countries before it gets the U.S.
Their plan was to start the pandemic in China, then to China's neighboring countries, finally to the West, so that they may blame the killing pandemic on China and seek compensation from China, and then invade China and divide up the land of China for themselves. Then in May of 2018, while the WHO was holding a global flu pandemic simulation that kills 30 million people, and the U.S. was holding the Clade X pandemic exercise, Fauci told 60 Minutes Australia, another pandemic, that is, COVID-19, is almost inevitable. In the same year, a coronavirus vaccine was patented in the United States. From January 2019 to August 2019, the Trump administration ran the Crimson Contagion simulation exercise. A pandemic of respiratory virus began in China and quickly spread around the world. 586,000 Americans killed. This shows Trump was aware of the Anglo-Saxon mission conspiracy. and was an accomplice in their war crime. On the 24th of January 2019, Bill H.R. 748, titled Middle Class Healthy Benefits Tax Repeal Act of 2019, was introduced. 1 month later, on the 6th of March, Bill S-648 was introduced, with exactly the same title. But this was no error. Bill S-648 was introduced so that Bill H.R. 748 could be amended and renamed as CARES, Coronavirus Aid, Relief, and Economic Security Act, enacted in time to beat the COVID pandemic. This shows the COVID-19 virus leak was discovered in February 2019, or earlier, during the 2018 and 2019 flu season. How did the U.S. manage to cover up the COVID-19 pandemic on American soil for a full year? Five reasons. First, COVID-19 symptoms are flu-like, malaria-like, and could be easily misdiagnosed. Second, the Fort Detrick lab leak occurred during the 2018 and 2019 flu season. So the CDC covered it up as flu. Third, as the flu season departing, CDC covered it up as vaping illness for young patients. Who are vapers? Because vaping makes people more susceptible to COVID-19. For the elderly COVID-19 patients, CDC labeled it as respiratory illness with unknown cause. Fourth, 80% of the COVID-19 cases are non-symptomatic, and of the 20% symptomatic, 80% have mild symptoms like common cold. Only 4% of the COVID-19 cases are severe. Fifth, CDC and FDA banned all coronavirus diagnostic tests till the 29th of February 2020. SARS-CoV-2 was found in a wastewater sample, dated the 12th of March 2019 in Spain. The invisible U.S. bioweapon was carried to Europe early 2019 by infected U.S. servicemen stationed in their 800 military bases around the world. By April 2019, the first COVID-19 outbreak with severe lung damages started among users of vaping products, exclusively in the U.S., though vapers are all over the world. CDC covered it up as vaping illness. The second COVID-19 outbreak occurred in a retirement home in Springfield near Fort Detrick on June 30, 2019.
Tonight, a deadly outbreak in Virginia. Two deaths and dozens of residents sickened by a respiratory illness here at the Green Spring Retirement Community.
For a respiratory outbreak to occur in July would certainly not be as likely as for it to occur during the winter.
Symptoms ranging from a bad cough to pneumonia. No promising leads on how the sudden illness broke out.
Sick residents have been quarantined to their rooms. New residents are not being admitted, and all staff are wearing masks and protective gloves until test results bring about answers.
CDC reported the outbreak as respiratory illness with unknown cause, because it was not the flu season, and the infected elderly did not vape. The third COVID-19 outbreak occurred in another retirement home in Fairfax near Fort Detrick in July 2019.
We now know a second Fairfax County retirement community is battling a respiratory illness outbreak. The health department telling us 25 people have gotten sick at Heatherwood in Burke. For two people, it has turned into pneumonia. No one has died. Heatherwood sits just 7 miles from Springfield's Green Spring retirement community, where three people have died. The Fairfax County Health Department says the CDC tested 17 samples from Green Spring, but the results don't give any clear answer to what the mystery illness is. The CDC tested 17 samples from Green Spring, but the results don't give any clear answer to what the mystery illness is. Since late June, more than 60 residents at Green Spring's Garden Ridge Extra Care Facility have gotten sick. About two dozen went to the hospital, and we've now learned nearly 20 employees have gotten sick also. Health officials say what makes these outbreaks unusual is when they are happening. They tell ABC 7 in the winter they're not unusual, but why they're happening in the summer remains a mystery.
Come on, this is no mystery to the CIA and CDC. Their Frankenstein bioweapon SARS-CoV-2 has escaped from their Nazi lab and pouring out its wrath on all Americans. To keep the world in the dark, CDC never identifies the cause, but it shut down the CIA bioweapon lab in Fort Detrick and slashed CDC staff in China right after the third COVID outbreak in July 2019. To deal with the COVID-19 pandemic raging in the U.S., because by July, Fort Detrick neighboring areas also reported higher than usual number of respiratory illnesses. By August 2019, COVID-19 disguised as vaping illness was widespread in the U.S.
The CDC currently investigating 193 severe pulmonary illnesses in people who use e-cigarettes. The cases spread out over 22 states. Among those hospitalized, 17-year-old Tristan Zofeld rushed to a Texas hospital with a blockage in his lungs. In late July, he was in a medically induced coma.
We don't see previously healthy 17-year-olds that sick.
China's Tianhe-1 supercomputer detected distinguished COVID lung features in the CAT image of a vaping illness patient who became severely ill between July and August in North Carolina. U.S. doctors ran tests for influenza and other known pathogens to identify the cause of infection, but the results came back negative. As the flu season arrived, vaping illness disappeared because CDC disguised COVID-19 as flu again, as more and more non-vapers caught COVID. Soon after CDC declared on January 21, 2020, a Seattle man returning from Wuhan as the first U.S. COVID-19 case, vaping illness miraculously disappeared from the American soil. COVID-19 was found already present in August 2019 or earlier in Japan, whose frozen serum dated September 24, 2019, tested positive for COVID antibody IgG. As you know, many U.S. soldiers stationed in Japan. In September 2019, Trump ordered the production of COVID-19 vaccines, but disguised them as flu vaccines. Trump's flu cover was blown away by Fauci, who approved an $18.9 million contract to Grefix for COVID-19 vaccine production in the same month, 3 months before the Wuhan outbreak. By September 2019, the Anglo-Saxon mission's biowarfare on China was widely known among the Western elite, a Washington, D.C. business executive told Micah Zenko, a highly contagious virus to begin in China. In October 2019, Maryland, the home state of the CIA bioweapon lab in Fort Detrick, reported higher than usual number of flu cases, but only 0.44% of the cases tested positive for flu. On the 18th of October 2019, the first day of the 7th Military World Games, the U.S. held Event 201 to simulate a novel coronavirus outbreak that would kill 65 million people worldwide. During the Wuhan Military Games in late October 2019, U.S. athletes became very sick with COVID-19 symptoms and were airlifted home. Meanwhile, COVID pneumonia was already circulating in Italy in October 2019.
E questo lo vedevano in ottobre, novembre, dicembre. Quindi questo virus circola da tanto tempo.
Between October 2019 and January 2020, nearly 5 million Americans caught COVID-19. According to a CDC blood donation sample study, where 1.43% of the blood donation samples collected between October 13, 2019 and January 17, 2020, found with COVID antibodies. This discovery agrees with the testimonies of many Americans that COVID-19 had hit the U.S. since early 2019. In a November 2019 Netflix film, Bill Gates declared a COVID-like outbreak to start at a Chinese market. Also in November 2019, CDC posted job listings, recruiting quarantine advisors for 19 U.S. cities. What had caused this huge sudden job demand? Also in November 2019, U.S. alerted Israel and NATO to the non-existent disease outbreak in China.
We are now learning that as far back as late November, American military medical investigators overseas sounded the alarm to officials right here at home about a contagion that was sweeping through Wuhan. Those concerns that the virus could be devastating were detailed in a report, and multiple sources have described that report to our team.
China identified SARS-CoV-2 only at the end of December 2019 and reported the outbreak on the 31st of December 2019. Also in November 2019, France confirmed its first COVID-19 case occurred on November 16, 2019. Many European athletes showed coronavirus symptoms following the World Military Games in Wuhan, late October 2019. U.S. Health Secretary Alex Azar admitted that the U.S. had been monitoring COVID-19 since December 2019, one full month before China's first report on the COVID-19 outbreak.
We've been monitoring this virus and preparing a response since back in December.
The 31st of December 2019 is the first day the world heard about the Wuhan outbreak. All who knew about the Wuhan outbreak before this day are culprits and accomplices of the Anglo-Saxon COVID-19 bio-warfare on China. In January 2020, Wilbur Ross says, coronavirus could bring jobs back to the U.S. from China, while Tom Cotton spreading disinformation that SARS-CoV-2 might be a Chinese bioweapon leaked from the Wuhan lab. In February 2020, while the U.S. bioweapon COVID-19 struck nearly 3,000 Chinese, Wall Street Journal launched media warfare against the Chinese people, demonizing China as the real sick man of Asia. Until the 29th of February 2020, FDA had banned COVID-19 diagnostic tests by state and commercial labs to help CDC cover up the Fort Detrick bioweapon leak. Even into March 2020, CDC still declined COVID-19 diagnostic tests for patients and healthcare practitioners to suppress the number of COVID-19 cases in the United States. Starting from March 2019, Trump's Chinese virus slur has incited worldwide hate crimes against Chinese and Asians. In April 2020, a hot mic leak revealed that the whole Trump gang were all vaccinated against COVID-19, 2 months after the first COVID-19 case was confirmed in the U.S. by CDC.
What's up, Barry?
All right, man.
Where do you go, babe?
You can take off the mask, Doug. The case fatality rate's like 0.1 to 0.3, according to
USC. Is it really? That's reassuring.
USC.
Everybody here's been vaccinated anyway.
By April 2020, malicious countries such as the U.S., U.K., India, Egypt, threatened China with lawsuits, demanding enormous financial compensations for the COVID-19 pandemic from China. In May 2020, Fauci told National Geographic, no scientific evidence the coronavirus was made in a Chinese lab. In May 2021, Fauci forked his tongue.
Are you still confident that it developed naturally?
Oh, I'm not convinced about that. I think that we should continue to investigate what went on in China until we find out, to the best of our ability, exactly what happened.
Fauci and all Western media forked their tongues to cover up the false flag of Biden, who ordered U.S. intelligence to reinvestigate COVID-19 origin in May 2021, so as to blame the U.S. bioweapon on China. In July 2021, after reviewing 4,000 patents issued around the SARS coronavirus, David Martin testified at the German-led Corona Investigative Committee that both SARS and SARS-CoV-2 were made in USA.
In 1999, Anthony Fauci funded research at the University of North Carolina, Chapel Hill, specifically to create, and you cannot help but lament what I'm about to read, because this comes directly from a patent application filed on April 19th, 2002, and you heard the date correctly, 2002, where the NIAID built an infectious replication defective coronavirus that was specifically targeted for human lung epithelium. In other words, we made SARS. We made SARS.
Now you know the truth. The truth is, USA made SARS. USA bombed China twice with SARS. The first time in November 2020. 829 Chinese were murdered. The second time in November 2019, 4,636 Chinese lost their lives. USA shamelessly claims its bioweapon COVID-19 leaked from Chinese lab in Wuhan and demands trillions of dollars of compensation from the victim it has bombed twice and killed thousands. The U.S. evil is unfathomable. Hell is made exclusively for the United States of Satan.